Can you just say
testing, that? 1, 2, 3, testing, testing.
Can I get you to state your name, where you're from, and what you do?
My name is Ben Newton. I'm from Arlington, Texas, and I'm a self-employed contractor.
You also live in Arlington?
No, I haven't. I was born in North Carolina and migrated to Texas in 1958.
What made you come here?
My parents gained work here.
And what made you stay?
I just like the openness of Texas, the big sky, so to speak.
Do you remember at all being aware of Kennedy as president?
No, I wasn't politically aware at all at that time. I was a very young child. I was in third grade, or actually I was in the first grade, I guess, when he was elected. So I was in the third grade when he got assassinated, and it made no difference to me. My life didn't change one iota.
Make a difference to the people around you?
No, I didn't hear anything around me at all. Just my parents weren't involved in that. We didn't care one way or the other. Maybe they hated him, I don't know. I'll have to ask him.
Do you still remember when it happened?
I remember when it happened because they, like my friend said before, they stopped school and announced it. That's all I remember, is that we got to stop and had a dead period where we did nothing but listen to that announcement. And I believe they let school out afterwards, so we got an early day.
Remember watching any television or anything?
Yeah, I remember they repeated it over and over on television, and I just hated that because it interrupted my television day, and I was really, I got tired of it quick.
You ever been a political person as you grew up?
Yes, I became very political in my latter years in high school, and got very politically involved.
In what way?
I was involved with the ACLU. American Civil Liberties Union.
Raising money?
Actually, no, trying to straighten out some bad school systems here in Texas. Actually, the one that I was involved in, which is the Bell High School in Hearst, is where I attended. And we just did some things to change Bell High School and their policies.
Do you have a party affiliation at all?
No. No, I was just more or less an independent person just trying to strike out for the righteousness of people that needed it.
Looking back now, what do you think of Kennedy?
I think of Kennedy as a colorful character. He was just a character to me. He got lots of attention for some reason, and I know he started the space program, and he said some profound things. Whether or not he wrote them or not, I'm not sure. I think he just repeated them. He was just a character to me. Him and LBJ both were just cartoon characters to me. I could care less about them.
Any presidents that you didn't care about or that struck you as different?
I like Jimmy Carter. I thought he was a very, very, very good president. I just sad that political policies at that time kind of strangled him and kept him from doing anything good.
So what do you think distinguishes a man like Carter from the rest of them?
Carter was a little bit more truthful, I think, than the rest of them. He was said the truth, and nobody liked it.
So what do you think, the world would be any different if Kennedy had not been killed?
I don't think it changed one bit. I think his policies and any other president's policies, as you can see by Jimmy Carter, who was able to get nothing done, those policies are controlled and go into effect only through political associations that are already rolling, whether they're president or not.
Does coming to Dealey Plaza give you any particular thoughts or feelings?
No, not really. Just a place to come, waste some time.
You think people always come here to waste some time?
I think people come here because it's curious. It has history. It has history.
Do you have any feelings about what happened that day, what really happened that day?
All I know is somebody got killed and somebody had to have killed him, but I have no time to waste on conspiracies. He's dead, that's all that matters to me.
So do you think people should just get over it?
Well, you know, if people have time to spend in that area, I guess it's okay for them to spend time. I just don't have time to spend in that area.
Do you have any feelings about them wanting to rename the street?
I think they shouldn't rename streets ever. For anybody, they should stay what they were named originally and not be changed, because then you don't know where you are anymore. People who've lived in the town, for instance, I have a friend's mother who would drive here and she would know where she was at because they've renamed the street. And doesn't she deserve a certain amount of respect for living here for that amount of time? What about all the people that have lived here all that time and the street was named that, and then you're just going to rename it because a few people want to rename it? I don't think that's fair or right.
Did you say, have you ever been up to the museum before?
No, I've never been up to the museum before. No, I haven't. I'm not going to spend that amount of money to go up there. If it were free, I would go up there, but I'm not going to go up there.
So it would have to be free?
It would have to be free for me to go up there. I'm just not interested enough to spend money on it.
Anything else that you can think of that would help people understand that time?
Oh, at that time, I think that the world wasn't quite as wound as tight as it is now. People seemed to be just so wound so tight. It was a little bit more relaxed, and people weren't in such a big hurry. We had more time to spend with people because there was less to do, if that makes sense.
Thank you very much.
All right. Mine did take 10 minutes.
Let me do it.
Oh, okay. I forgot about that.